Hello, friends, and greetings from Quito's, Peru. It's, I believe, Wednesday, December 8th or something like that. And I am going to try to catch up now and do what I said and give you a little report of my adventures thus far. I arrived on Sunday morning in Lima, or actually Saturday night in Lima, and then Sunday morning here in Quito's. On arrival, I found my friend Bjorn's place, hooked up with him, started chewing some coca leaves, and got acquainted with the place here. And the very same evening, after a little bit of a nap, because I'd been up for over 24 hours on my journey here, I drank ayahuasca with Bjorn and Peter, who's from Slovenia, and with Irena, who's from Russia. Bjorn and Peter are both shamans, ayahuasca shamans. Their ayahuasca is about the strongest you can find in Quito's. I drank some from them, and I drank one cup from them, and I drank one cup from a local guy, a local Peruvian named Joel. I sat and waited to see what would happen, and was looking forward to trying to withhold expectation, yet I kind of had some expectation that something would happen. But after first hour and second hour, I waited, nothing happened, nor I couldn't throw up. After I had the first cup, and then after an hour and a half, I took another cup, but I really couldn't throw up, which is all called purging, which is part of the process. So I was a little disappointed, and so I went and laid down on the bench. We had some like benches and some places set up to rest, and I laid down for maybe 15, 20 minutes while Peter sang some. He's a great singer and sang beautiful mantras, both Spanish ones and also Vedic ones, mantras in Sanskrit. And Bjorn began playing on the drums with a powerful drum, like the drums of Thor. He's a Viking, a leader of a group called the Vikingos. And I was lying there, and all of a sudden I thought, well, what am I doing just lying here resting? Let me get up and have fun, enjoy myself, even if I'm not gonna have any ayahuasca experience. And it was actually the music and the drumming, which I'm a sucker for music. It's part and particle of what's important in life for me. And so I got up, started snapping my fingers, started feeling the energy, and soon we were all just doing music and having a great time. And hours went by, but I didn't have any real experience. That I didn't really notice anything, any feeling from the ayahuasca. And finally, around, I don't know what time it was, maybe 5 in the morning, everybody got ready to go to sleep. I was about to help show Irene upstairs with my flashlight, because she didn't have one. And I said, wait, I think I have to go to the bathroom before I go. And so I walked into the bathroom, and they all kind of filed out and left. And it was the Maloka that we were in. And then, as I got in the bathroom, I suddenly fell apart. I started losing my balance. I started like kind of bouncing off the sides of the toilet, like the walls. I couldn't stand up straight. I was literally bouncing from the walls. I could barely like stand up to like pull my pants down. And I finally was able to get settled there, and I had like suddenly, like, you know, like my guts, like just pouring out and puking, and it was bitter, and I was there for I don't know how long, and then I got out, and I was so dizzy, and so I couldn't barely walk. I managed to get over to the bench and lie down, and I felt really physically bad, how do I explain what's the timing? I felt really, really physically in bad shape, but then there, I started having, it wasn't a visual experience, but I had an experience of this consciousness that started flowing so rapidly, and I went to such a high level of consciousness, but yet it was, we could say, mind-blowing, mind-expanding. It was uncomfortable. It was like, I think you call it cosmic consciousness. Something to an extent that was just overwhelming and frightening, and I didn't know. I didn't know what to make of it. Meanwhile, physically, I felt like I was absolutely not. I was not really in good shape. I kept trying to get up, but I would tip over, and my body was like failing me. Like I wasn't able to hold myself up, and I felt sick. Witch's brew. Yeah, I was drinking the witch's brew. And the song is by one of my favorite groups, and it's a song about the abuse of women throughout the Middle Ages and the horrible persecutions that were done against women, from the fear of women, and that's why we are taking down the patriarchy and why we're beginning to raise up the divine feminine. But anyway, that's another story. Anyway, so I went to trying to get upstairs, and as I was going up the stairs, I couldn't, I was just staggering, and I felt like physically like awful, and like I didn't understand why all that was happening, because that's one thing I didn't expect. I didn't know that I would get that kind of I knew you'd get, you know, you have to purge, you get, you know, diarrhea, you puke, normal, but I was physically just collapsing, and I crawled up the stairs, and I got up one level up, I could barely tell where I was, and I was trying to get up another two levels to my rooftop where I live, and I couldn't, and so I crawled out onto the balcony. And as I got out on the balcony, I just drew down a towel I was carrying and collapsed there. And as I lie there on this cement balcony, I lay on the ground, almost like collapsed, as if I'd been shot or something. As if I just kind of twitching, and I felt like I could be dying, and as I sat there, I imagined all the poor guys who've been shot for no reason by so many militaries, including mine and the French and the Israelis and every Russians and everybody. Just that whole experience of, you know, you're sitting there and RPG hits. You're still surviving, and then they come and finish you off, but in those moments, you're just lying there, twitching on the ground, helpless, ready to die, and that's no problem. You can come say hello, come over, come here. This is Irena. This is Irena. She's staying here too, in this lodge. So, if you come, you'll meet her. So anyway, I lay there and I thought, well, if I die now, that would be according to the plan. It'll work out fine. I didn't mention. I felt a sense of a little bit of a panic when I was in the toilet down below before, because I really was just collapsing, and all of a sudden I said to myself, I thought, man, this is, it was really awful. I mean, really, really, really hard, like hard shit. But then I just smiled all of a sudden. I thought, love is my guide, and then I thought this is all got to be some kind of purpose, all this. And I smiled to myself, and that like steadied me. Anyway, same thing out on the balcony. I thought, it's, you know, if this is the moment for me that I was to die, that would be, I have a feeling it's gonna work out fine. It'll work out for the best. That's Peter in the background. He's one of the shamans here. He's from Slovenia, an excellent guy, with beautiful singer, and knows how to cook amazing ayahuasca. So anyway, so I lay there on the cement balcony for a while, but I didn't die. And after a while, I kept trying to sit up, and I kept tipping over. I couldn't hold myself up. I don't know why that experience came, but finally, after some time more had gone by, I crawled up the stairs, basically. I crawled up two flights up to the roof, and at that point I finally was able to get myself in my hammock. I didn't get in the hammock. I collapsed on the floor up there. I couldn't even get in my hammock, which was hanging there. I just fell down on the floor and lay there. And I kept trying to get up repeatedly, like a baby, you know, like a baby that doesn't want to walk. I kept getting up and I kept tipping over. And finally I got up and I was on my feet and I was kind of swaying back and forth and I couldn't walk. But then I just started to dance and like kind of like started spinning around and then dancing back and forth. And all of a sudden I found out that I couldn't walk, but I could dance. So I danced and I started dancing faster and faster. And I had my music on and all of a sudden I felt this, like all this energy, and I felt this incredibly, I don't know, I became overwhelmed with like incredibly good feeling of endless overflowing energy and health and vibrancy and excitement. And I danced up there for maybe an hour or two, I don't really know, with just, as you know, with the sun coming up over the jungle, and it was absolutely beautiful. And I felt, As to the depths of the badness or harshness that I had experienced and felt, I felt just as far up the other direction. It was really amazing. I questioned to myself. I mean, it came out. I felt wonderful, but I asked myself, would I wish this on a friend or on my, like say, on my children or on my, you know, other family members or whatever? Would I wish it on them? Because I don't want to wish that kind of hardship on anybody, that kind of suffering. Yet the upside of it was pretty good. So I guess I won't wish it on anybody, but I'll let people decide for themselves. It doesn't always, not everyone has that experience, by the way. You never know what experience you're gonna have. That's part of the thing. And the interesting thing is, like, for the whole night, I didn't have any feeling at all, and I didn't think anything was happening. I couldn't throw up. I felt totally fine. I didn't feel any feeling of purging. I started to feel it in my intestines, something, but all of a sudden, it came from everywhere, and I just fell apart. It was like, and then the consciousness raising. I don't think my consciousness ever went to such a level. I can't even put into words what I went through, what I experienced and thought. So it was truly amazing. Now I'm preparing to sit and drink ayahuasca again, just a small group. Interesting, we're all gringos. It was last time also, and same thing tonight, just gringos. Authentic is a word that you have to be careful with. We are very authentic, but we were gonna sit with a Peruvian tonight, but he didn't show up. So the Peruvians aren't known for promise. We'll do it with them another time. It's no big deal. So it's going to be just the three of us tonight. Peter and Irene and myself. I wish you could be here. You it would be something you wouldn't want to miss. But I say to you, I love you. I wish you well. Come down and see us. And vaya con Dios. Take care.
Hey.